Let's talk about that notebook for a minute, okay? If you're going to approach this seriously, you really want to keep track of where you are. And the best way to do that is with a notebook. And, you know, even you guys that live on computers and iPhones, and boy, I spend a lot of my day on computers, okay? I think that doing it on paper is better because you can carry it with you in your gig bag with your bass, okay? A three-ring binder, you can get them at the office stores or, you know, the Biggie Mart, whatever. And you just need, you know, about an inch, maybe an inch and a half, if you're really studious, and a three-hole punch and some lined paper. And you have different sections for scales, riffs, songs, turnarounds. You can group it any way you want, but scales and basic riffs are two really good ones. And what you do, for instance, with a scale, let's say you're working on your minor pentatonic in all your keys, and on the E minor pentatonic on Monday, you practiced that one and you built your speed up. So you note that, and you worked on the G minor, and you worked on the B minor, but you didn't do the B flat because that's a weird one and you don't like that. So Tuesday, you need to go back to that B flat minor pentatonic and work on that. And keep track of all of those things so that you know where to apply your effort. And as we go on through these lessons, as I create this library, we'll talk about more areas to focus on. But for right now, let's just figure out a way for you to make notes every lesson or every rehearsal session what you practiced and what you accomplished. And then at the end of the week, you can look back and say, hey, I got a pretty good amount done, but I see that I need to continue working here and here, so that's what I'm going to do this weekend. Okay? Go get yourself a one-inch binder, get yourself some lined paper, maybe a three-hole punch. That'll help you keep track of what you're doing as you're learning bass. I'm Lane on bass. Y'all keep thumping. Talk to you soon.